We all know that the first two rules of Fight Club is that we don't talk about Fight Club. Well, we're gonna break both those rules today, and we're gonna talk about BAMO, in which Kung Fu practitioners put their skills to the test in secret illegal street fights. If you haven't seen it already, the new movie, The Paper Tigers, has just been released in theaters and simultaneous streaming. The movie kind of snuck up and popped out there, but it's a pleasantly charming, fun kung fu movie. It takes itself seriously with just enough dark comedy to balance it out. It also features everyone's favorite and undoubtedly most complete martial arts master. Now, one of the main elements that the story rides on is the concept of BAMO, or challenges issued among the characters in the film. So spoiler alert, we're going to talk just a little bit about the movie for a moment, so if you want to skip it and jump directly to where we talk about BAMO, you can click on the link in the description and skip ahead. The Paper Tigers is a story of three friends growing up training Kung Fu together under the private tutelage of their Sifu. Through the use of home video clips, we see their development as they come of age, develop and hone their skills, and become known as the Three Tigers, the fiercest fighters in town. After a falling out splits the group, they all go their own ways and they drift apart. 30 years later, they are reunited after the death of their Sifu in what progresses as a kung fu mystery with plenty of action, humor, and just enough reality about aging martial artists that it can hit pretty close to home. BAMO plays a pretty big role in the film. We see early on that Sifu does not approve of them using the training for vanity in local fights, but the Three Tigers continue to pursue it, going dojo storming and challenging other martial arts disciplines. But as the Tigers progressed in life, the concept of BAMO goes from cocky, back-alley fights for pride and escalates to more serious levels as the now-grown men get closer to solving the mystery and fighting themselves, encountering stronger and more dangerous threats. If you haven't seen the film, I definitely recommend giving it a watch. It's a surprisingly wholesome film that balances out action and character drama well enough. But what exactly is BAMO, and is it a real thing? Well, BAMO absolutely is a real thing, and it first saw an establishment in Hong Kong, specifically in the British colony, in the 50s and 60s for practitioners of various Chinese arts to test their arts in a street fighting setting with little to no rules. More accurately, Bei, to compare, and Mao, martial, BAMO translates to comparing martial skills. These challenges often took place in back alleys, rooftops, parks, really any place of convenience where the fights could be carried out discreetly because they were often illegal. While there were typically no rules or time limits in these fights, there were sometimes unwritten codes such as, you know, trying not to kill your opponent. These fights were prohibited by the government and were often considerably dangerous. Environmental hazards, the lack of protective gear, full contact, and the goal of knocking out or incapacitating your opponent made BAMO something to take seriously. Another major notable note regarding the history of BAMO is that this was an opportunity for practitioners of Wing Chun to shine and bring more awareness to the art. Many notable Wing Chun practitioners were known or suspected to have participated, but you can't talk about BAMO and Wing Chun without mentioning Wong Sengling, a well-known disciple under Wing Chun Grandmaster Ip Man. Wong carried the reputation of being a fierce and dominating opponent. Stories of his fights and victories earned him the nickname Gong Sao Wong, or King of Talking Hands. Some witness accounts even go as far to claim that most of his fights ended with only a few moves. He is also often credited with being one of Bruce Lee's trainers, as well as helping bring Wing Chun out of obscurity and helping it become an established Chinese martial arts system. The unfortunate thing about BAMO was that since many of these fights were illegal and spontaneous and taking place in a time before cameras were really readily available, there was very little documented footage of such competitions. Snippets are out there, including this famous clip that shows a rooftop challenge, but as a result, it is often difficult to know exactly what the outcomes were. Many fighters were quiet about their involvement, but many boasted about it. It was also not uncommon for the losing opponent to deny involvement or to also claim victory, so sometimes the history does get a little bit muddy. Regardless, Wong's name emerged as a fierce and reputable fighter, and he went on to become a driving force behind the art of Wing Chun. He was upfront about his involvement in the challenges, once stating in an interview, "When I competed, it was in secret. We went into a room, and the door was shut, and there were no rules. The government did not allow them. They were illegal, but we didn't care. We fought until the other guy was knocked out." Wong frowned upon taking part in fights with rules, and he liked the practical application and the possibilities of testing your art against a real opponent. While he had experience in a few different arts, he established his roots in Wing Chun and quite literally walked the talk. He became faithful to the art upon meeting Ip Man for the first time. He also described his experience in the same interview. "When I first joined, I sparred with two of his students and beat them even before Ip Man had taught me anything. Then It Man fought with me, and I felt that the way he beat me was so smooth and so convincing that I wanted to learn from him. He controlled me without hitting me at all and stopped my punches. I immediately recognized that I had been bettered. Just like many martial arts out there, there are mixed opinions on Wing Chun and disputes among lineage and all of your standard politics. However, what I really respect about the scenario of Baymo is it wasn't about being showy, it wasn't about magic martial arts or smoke and mirrors, it was about making your skills work in a real fight. So regardless of any opinions on the arts practice, the participants of Baymo in the 50s and 60s Hong Kong should get a little bit of respect for stepping up and pitting themselves in real fights for the integrity of effective martial arts training. So once again, if you haven't seen the film, I do recommend checking out The Paper Tigers. And if you've already seen it, I would love to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. But please be respectful and label any spoiler alerts. Thanks for watching, and we'll face off next week.
Fight is over.